Good morning. Good morning, love. It's my favorite love song. I waited all night long.
Come on, Robert, because you're kicking it off today.
Let's kick it.
Morning, everybody. Welcome back to the Brekkie Bar. Today we're doing chapter 5 of Luke. Page 12, Robert. You ready? Come on. You don't need to do that.
As Yahusha stood beside Lake Galilee, a crowd of people pushed to get closer to him and to hear the teachings of Yahuwah. Yahusha saw two boats at the shore of the lake. The fishermen were washing their nets. Yahusha got into the boat that belonged to Simon. He asked Simon to push off a little from the shore, and he sat down in the boat and taught the people on the shore.
Marty, you want to read next one?
When Yahusha finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Take the boat into the deep water. If all of you will put your nets into the water, you will catch some fish." Simon answered, "Master, we worked hard all night trying to catch fish and caught nothing. But you say I should put the nets into the water, so I will?" The fishermen put their...
Hang on a second, because you made that sound like a question. He's making a statement. "So I will." Yeah? Mm. Keep going now.
The fishermen put their nets into the water. Their nets were filled with so many fish that they began to break. They called to their friends in the other boat to come and help them. The friends came, and both boats were filled so full of fish that they were almost sinking. The fishermen were all amazed at the many fish they caught. When Simon Peter saw this, he bowed down before Yahusha and said, "Go away from me, Master. I am a sinful man." James and John, the sons of Zebedee, were amazed too. James and John worked together with Simon. Yahusha said to Simon, "Don't be afraid. From now on, your work will be to bring in people, not fish." The men brought their boats to the shore. They left everything and followed Yahusha.
Pena?
One time Yahusha was in a town where a very sick man lived. This man was covered with leprosy. When the man saw Yahusha, he bowed before him. And begged him, "Master, you have the power to heal me if you want." Yahusha said, "I do want, and you are healed." Then he touched the man, and immediately the leprosy disappeared. Then Yahusha said, "Don't tell anyone about what happened, but go and let the priest look at you and offer a gift to Yahuwah for your healing, as Moses commanded. This will show people that you are truly healed." But the news about Yahusha spread more and more. Many people came to hear him and to be healed of their sicknesses. Yahusha often went away to other places to be alone so that he could pray.
Luca?
One day Yahusha was teaching the people. The Pharisees and teachers of the law were sitting there too. They had come from every town in Galilee and Judea. And from Jerusalem, the Father was giving Yahusha the power to heal people. There was a man who was paralyzed, and some of the men were carrying him on the mat. They tried to bring him and put him down before Yahusha. But there were so many people that they could not find a way to Yahusha. So they went up on the roof and lowered the crippled man down through a hole in the ceiling. They lowered the mat into the room so that the crippled man was lying before Yahusha. Yahusha saw how much belief they had and said to the sick man, "Friend, your sins are forgiven."
John?
The Jewish teachers of the law and the Pharisees thought to themselves, "Who is this man who dares to say such things? What an insult to Elohim. No one but Elohim can forgive sins." But Yahusha knew what they were thinking and said, "Why do you have these questions in your mind? The Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins, but how can I prove this to you? Maybe you are thinking it was easy for me to say, 'Your sins are forgiven.' There's no proof that it really happened, though, is there? But what if I say to the man, 'Stand up and walk'? Then you will be able to see that I really have this power." So Yahusha said to the paralyzed man, "I tell you, stand up, take your mat, and go home." The man immediately stood up in front of everyone. He picked up his mat and walked home, praising Yahweh. Everyone was completely amazed and began to praise Yahweh. They were filled with great respect for Yahweh's power. They said, "Today we saw amazing things."
Mikey?
After this, Yahusha went out and saw a tax collector sitting at his place for collecting taxes. His name was Levi. Yahusha said to him, "Follow me." Levi got up, left everything, and followed Yahusha. Then Levi held a big dinner at his house for Yahusha. At the table, there were many tax collectors, and some other people too. But the Pharisees and those who taught the law for the Pharisees began to complain to the followers of Yahusha, "Why do you eat and drink with tax collectors and other sinners?" Yahusha answered them, "It is the sick people who need a doctor, not those who are healthy. I have not come to ask good people to repent and change. I have come to deliver the sinners so that they can be made whole again."
Pina?
They said to Yahusha, "John's followers often fast and pray, same as the followers of the Pharisees. But your followers eat and drink all the time." Yahusha said to them, "At a wedding, you can't ask the friends of the bridegroom to be sad and fast while he is still with them. But the time will come when the groom will be taken away from them. Then his friends will fast."
Keep going.
Yahusha told them this story. "No one takes cloth off a new coat to cover a hole in an old coat. That would ruin the new coat. And the cloth from the new coat would not be the same as the old cloth. Also, no one ever pours new wine into old wineskins. The new wine would break them. The wine would spill out, and the wineskins would be ruined. You always put new wine into new wineskins. No one who drinks old wine wants new wine. They say, 'The old wine is just fine.'"
Read that little writing underneath.
"New teachings and instructions must be written on a new heart by a new spirit. For without this divine heart operation, no seeds of deliverance can be planted to begin the transformation and training process within the genuine applicant. This happens at repentance and immersion in Yahusha's name."
What a fantastic chapter. What'd you get out of that, Micah? What was Yahusha saying to you while you were reading and listening to everyone read?
that if we trust Yahushua and do what he says, great things will happen and we'll get like blessings and gifts.
I'll have a look at the part that you read where he says, take your boat into the deep water, put your nets in, you'll catch fish. And these guys are like, we've been out all night, we're exhausted, but we'll do it because you told us to do it. And what happened?
They caught more fish than they could hold. They thought they would.
They needed a second boat to put all those fish in. So yes, both right. How about that? Could you imagine trying to do that? You've just been out all night trying to catch fish.
Caught nothing.
Yeah. And suddenly Yahushua says to you, go on out. You're going to get something now. You watch. And the boats were almost to the point of capsizing. They were so full. Could you imagine how amazed and overjoyed these guys were? They had the belief. You said to do it, so we will do it. Yeah? That's what Yahushua is saying to us. If I say to do it, do it. That's you standing on your belief. Yeah? Bit like the guy with the leprosy. If you want to heal me, you can. Yahushua says, well, I want to heal you, so you healed. Yeah? Same goes for everyone that is in the bride. If you want to be healed, ask. And you will be healed. The only thing that Yahushua asks from us is the right behavior. That's all. And I don't think that's too much for someone to ask, considering he laid his life out for us. Yeah? What about you, Joe? What did you get from
it? Ask Yahushua for stuff. Like, not stupid stuff, but like actual stuff that would help people and believe that he'll do it.
Yeah. That's it. From what I'm seeing, so far every chapter is about everybody having belief and standing firm in that belief. We've seen it with Mary. See it here with Simon, and then you see it with the guy with leprosy. All the way along, everybody is believing in what they've heard. Yeah? And they're standing firm. They're not faltering. They're not listening to the wicked ones. Yeah? What about you, Pina? What'd you get?
That as long as you believe, you can be healed.
Good. What about where the Pharisees say about Yahushua's followers not fasting? Trying to catch him out. What about that? Now, if you had a wedding feast, you're going to be sad that they're right there with him, aren't you? So you're celebrating. Yeah? When they go, that's when you start to fast, is what Yahushua's saying. Why would you fast when somebody is actually with you? Yeah? I find it amazing the way the Pharisees are always trying to catch him out in everything. But they don't only do it to him, they do it to his followers. And then you see all these other people who have belief that is untold.
Leave the tissues alone.
It's enough now.
Sit still.
Yeah? That's the belief that we all need in everything that we hear from him. And you'll know if it's him, and you know when it isn't.
Mm.
Anybody know how you know the difference?
Because you feel cut off when you do the things that aren't from him.
Yeah. Very true. That's very true. So you always got to make sure that you're standing firm in your belief. Yeah? No, not doing that. Because you can tell. Oh, why don't you go and jump off a bridge, for example? No, I'm not saying any of you have had this thought, but people do get these thoughts. All right? Go and jump off a bridge. You think Yahushua's going to tell you go jump off a bridge? Or would Yahushua say, go and give your dad a hug. Go and give your mum a hug. Go and give your brother a high five. Yeah? Go and help your brother out. Isn't that something that would come in from Yahushua? Because what are we? What are we? Are we high and mighty like the Pharisees and Sadducees?
Mm.
What are we?
We're the sinners. We're the servants.
Exactly. We're servants for Yahushua, aren't we? So if he tells you to go and help somebody, you do it. He tells you to do something, you do it. Usually the stuff that comes from Satan is negative. Oh, see? Look at the way he treats that one. Oh, what about what he's doing there? It's not from Yahushua, is it? You see how you can tell the difference? And Satan's very unoriginal. Tells everybody the same thoughts at some point. Isn't that right, darling?
Hmm.
Got to remember, don't listen to those negative thoughts. You've got a portal, a permanent connection. The only one who can cut that connection is who?
Us.
That's it. Each person individually. You can't blame anybody else for it because it's your choice. Your choice to do the wrong thing or the wrong behavior, wrong attitude. That's all. When I say your choice, I mean each person's individually. Yeah? So we've got to stand firm. Listen to what Yahushua's telling us. Yeah?
Hmm.
Sound like a good point?
Yeah.
You got anything else, darling?
That's great.
All right, brothers and sisters, that's it for today. We'll see you for another Breaky Bar soon.
Good morning. It's a beautiful day when I'm with her. With me, she lays. Good morning. Another beautiful day. The sun rises when I see your face every day. Good morning. Good morning.